Good day, everybody. It is AirPirateCid, and welcome back to more Let's Play Golden Sun. The last chapter, we ended up saving Trent and all the people of Kalumia, and, well, it seemed like we were about to get in trouble, but no, we were never placed under arrest. Instead, we are able to actually be rewarded. All right. Also, before I continue gameplay, I'm going to go on ahead and apologize for, probably not having a good update schedule for, like, the past week. Well, as most of you should know, I just came back from a convention, and usually whenever I come back from conventions, whenever I don't have pre-recorded episodes, I tend to stall whenever I start recording stuff. But here I am starting a recording, so I'm getting back into motion, I'm getting back into my groove and all that good stuff. So, well, yeah, I guess that it's AirPirateCid's new groove. For those of you who actually understand that movie reference, I congratulate you. For those of you who don't, you really need to watch Disney movies. Anyways, gameplay time. Yeah, whenever we last left off, we were able to choose a reward from one of these four treasure chests. Alright, I'm going to lay it down for you. You get a vial if you choose this, which is obviously the crappiest item you can get. You get a potion if you choose this, which is alright, but not really worth it. If you choose this chest, then you could get a Psy Crystal. And if you choose this chest, we get the best item that you could possibly get. A Water of Life! Ho-ho, yes! Once again, another reviving item that we can always use. Yeah, thank you for always welcoming us to the Palace of Lord McCoy. But we are pretty well done here. So actually, let's go on ahead and give that to Garrett right now. So that way, now you have two of them. Let's see. Oh yeah, I also forgot about that, because I was thinking, wait, shouldn't you have two of each, but I guess I didn't give that to him. Going ahead and use the hard nut. Let's see, you have 83, 86, 72, and 81. Alright, we'll give it to you. Now, let's see, give the potion also to Garrett. Make him carry more useless stuff. Haha, you're the pack mule, Garrett! We snall! Yeah, that was actually, horse, I do believe. Alright, well, we're done here, so... People of Kalumia are now why do I keep calling it Kalumia? It's Kalima and Billabin. So, yeah, but if you actually... Wait, no, I already showed that. You already saved them, and then after that, that's how I got the hard nut. It's been like a week since I've last played this game, viewers, so I apologize for that. But at the same time, I don't really apologize, because I was having fun at a convention. And after that, I just kind of lost track of time and everything. So, let's see. Run around those kids. We don't need to talk to them. All they do is just say stuff as, like, water never tastes so good or something like that. Well, let's go on ahead and buy some armor. Let's see. Adept's clothes. Would they really work? Oh, wait. Wait a second. I think I've already bought some stuff that I don't really need, haven't I? Yes, I have. Okay. Well, I'm kind of refreshing my own memory with this, so... Yeah, I remember already being here and everything, but... Now that we've already gone back to Billabin, it's time to actually continue on with the storyline and go explore more of the map that we have not explored yet! I can't believe I actually got off, like, all these sentences without running into a random battle, but... Yeah, if you came here earlier whenever the curse was still going on, the people that are about to lower the bridge, or that person who's gonna lower the bridge, he would have been a tree, and he wouldn't have been able to have done anything because, well, he was a tree. Boosh! Okay, well, that was fun. Let's talk to you again. For a while, I thought no one would ever cross the bridge again. Enjoy every crossing, for it could be your last! Yeah, that is true. It's just like how everyone here needs to enjoy life a lot, because if you don't, well, it's the only life you get. You need to enjoy it. Okay, that battle was nothing but oozes, stuff that we've already seen before. I'm pretty sure that we can run into new enemies here, but... Eh, well, not in this video anyways. Yeah, if you go on here, because this is where we need to go next, we need to go on ahead, well... Yeah, I don't feel like talking to any of these people. They look too much like Aang from Avatar. Only their outfits aren't quite like his. Alright, well, if you go on ahead and check this... Oh, wait, why did I move? Check the stupid jar, Isaac. There we go! We can actually get a Unicorn's Ring, which is always very nice to have because, well, it's just a piece of equipment that we'll end up selling. If you talk to this guy, all he does is just say a bunch of dots. Well, let's mind read him. Who is that? Who speaks to my mind? Obviously me, because I'm the only one here. Young Master, was that your voice I just heard in my mind just now?
Yes, it was.
I knew it! You follow them, do you not? I don't know who them are or who they are. I don't know where I'm going with the grammar, viewers. You know everything, don't you? You're like one of those master kung fu artist people who... Well, wait, why did I call them artists? But you must go through Mogul Forest, the endless woods. The forest itself is a mystery, and its paths are even more so. No ordinary man can pass from one side to the other. But perhaps I could, young master. Why do you call me young master? I'm not master of anything. If you can endure the trials of the Waterfall Grotto, I will tell you. Will you take the test? Yeah, I don't have much of a choice, so sure. Do not worry, you will be permitted to enter the grotto. Yay, I thought I would have to be so worried about not entering that grotto. Not really. And how did you know my name? Okay, well, I guess that explains it. He already says that. He reads my name. Okay, moving on. By the way, if you need to heal up, I strongly recommend that you, well, do it here in wrong button. Because you could go on ahead and cure everyone with Isaac and there, if that grabbed the Synergy crystal here, or the Synergy stone, whatever. And, well, it pretty much, you know, gives everyone max MP again. And seeing as how there's nothing more of interest here, we just talk to this guy. Alright, and he does, like, an incredible RPG-defying jump! Oh yeah, you can't do those in RPGs nowadays, viewers. Why? Because RPGs do not allow you to jump. I still don't even understand why they don't, but whatever. The dragon's flame illuminates the path of truth and darkness. Yeah, keep that in mind, because that's like part of a riddle. And, whoa, we need to actually go back to that other treasure chest. Why is that, viewers? Well, actually, let's go on ahead and set all my gin here. Or, yeah, because we are about to fight a mimic! Alright, let's, whoa, no. Go on ahead and summon, I'm just gonna summon everything from the get-go, just to do a lot of damage. Usually my style is use the djinn during the battle, and then pretty much whittle it down to summoning, but I think that using summons first is probably more advantageous to the fact that everyone's, you know, like their wind power, or holy shaboopy, that was a lot of damage. But anyways, reason why I say that is because, well, like everyone's, you know, certain elemental powers are being increased from the very start, so that way if they use Synergy, it will be dealing more damage. So let's see here. Go on ahead and cast Cure Well on Mia there. Just attack Garrett, and as for you, can't quite do anything, so... Fuzz. He's probably going to end up dying. Let's see. Let's go on ahead and try casting Fly on him. Just to see if we can't get lucky. And there's Mia being fully restored, and... Okay, woo! Woo! I thought that he was actually about to attack Ivan. Alright, well. Everyone is pretty well restored, and everyone's gin starts getting set again. Yay for having set gin. Okay, well, time to go on ahead and lay waste to this guy. So, nah, don't cast Biz. Just attack. Aw, come on! You should have attacked more than once, man. There we go, alright. And Mimic is down. Isaac is now on level 12. And I'm pretty sure that he already grew to level 12 before in a previous episode, or in a previous episode, or chapter, as I call them. But due to reasons, I had to end up re-recording, and yeah, he didn't really stay quite leveled up or something like that. Yeah, so... Like I've already said before, viewers, it's been a little bit since I last played this. Well, anyways, going ahead and go up here. We don't need to go that way. Wait, yes we do. Crap, what the hell am I thinking? Going ahead and jump up here. Come on. There we go, and jump down here. I'm pretty sure this is where we need to go. Or at least I hope it is, anyways. Ha, that skeleton stood no chance against me. I wiped him clean from the earth. Or wiped him off the face of the earth, rather. Yeah, that one. Yeah, let's not go down yet, because I see a treasure chest over there on the left. And I know exactly what it is, viewers, but you probably don't. But you will hear in a second. The Arctic Blade! And seeing as how Isaac got the Elven Rapier, I'm going to go on ahead and give the Arctic Blade to Garrett there so that way he will be stronger and all that good stuff. So, next good weapon that Isaac and Garrett can get, Isaac's going to get it compared to Garrett because, well, Garrett just got this one. Like I've already said, I'm going to be shifting back and forth between, like, good weapons like that. Okay, nothing down there. And yeah, you can walk across the spikes if you want to get damage, but I don't feel like doing it because they are easily avoidable. Move on there and go down there. Aha! Now, I'm pretty sure that there is a Jupiter Djinn here. Or Djinni. Okay, hey, there it is. Speak of the devil. Alright. So go on ahead and do that. Jump across and go over there. Alright, yep, everyone's at full health. Let's go on ahead and have Isaac set those, and we're pretty well good to go. Haha! I shall do battle with you, Jupiter Djinn, and I shall win. Hopefully. If I don't win, viewers, well, I'm sorry, I'll let you down. Haha! 63, did you? 2 damage. Yeah, Mia is, for some odd reason, like, weak to wind attacks. As I have found out through this game, Garrett is weak to Earth. I'm not quite sure what Isaac and... Wait, I think that Ivan is weak to Fire, and there we go, alright, already won. But, wait, no, Ivan was weak to Water. I think that Isaac might be weak to Fire. I'm not exactly sure how exactly that goes on, because, you know... Wait, give that to him. He needs that. But, like, you know, you would expect that Water be weak to Fire, and Fire be weak to Water, and Wind and Earth be weak to each other, or something like that, but not in this game, apparently. Everything is a certain type of element that has their own strength and weakness according to its own uniqueness, I guess, would be the proper term. Let's go on ahead and just, you know, go lumberjack style on that log and go up here. Because I'm pretty gosh darn positive. Wait, wrong way. I'm pretty positive that we need to grab something up here. Yeah, it's down there, actually. Let's go on ahead and jump up there. Yeah, these puzzles are very, very simple, viewers, and if you kind of get stuck on them, just please don't share that information with people because they might think that you're, well, dumb. And we get the Dragon's Eye, which is a key item that we need in order to complete this dungeon. Well, actually, you don't need it to complete the dungeon, but it would be the legit way of doing it. That skeleton just got annihilated. Now, the reason why I didn't edit out that fight is because, well, I was in the middle of a sentence, and if you go to the eye, it is a statue of an eyeless dragon. What when it sockets? Gee, viewers, take a guess, the Dragon's Eye. If you said Dragon Ball, you're just way off. But, yeah. Now, whenever you see that, you kind of see, like, a shadow right there. Well, guess what, viewers? Well, my throat's kind of giving out right now because I guess I sort of coughed earlier. But, yeah, you go on ahead and go over here. Jump on over here. Once again. Don't really need to go in that middle hole right there. Because, well, all you'll basically get is just another hint of what to do next, and I'm pretty sure these are new enemies that I haven't shown before, so I guess I'll go on ahead and show them now. Go on ahead and cast Flare Wall on them, because I'm pretty sure that they're weak to fire. So, oh well, apparently they might be weak to Earth, but I'm not sure what the Elven Rapier has its own elemental attack, and I think it's Wind, possibly. So, let's go on ahead and have you cast Whirlwind, just to kind of find out. Yep. Apparently, the Elven Rapier is a wind attribute weapon. I never knew that. Yeah, if you go down the middle hallway right there, you'll just basically run across that and, well, it'll tell you what to do. And, yep, it's an invisible bridge, viewers. Didn't see that coming, did you? And I actually did a test recording before this one, and I kind of did not use the Dragon's Eye, and I was confused. I was like, wait, what the hell am I doing? I'm walking in midair? What? And then after that, I found out what I did wrong, and, well, I didn't grab the Dragon's Eye. But if you check this treasure chest, you get the Orb of Force! Alright. Well, Isaac just now got the catch bead, so we're going to get the Orb of Force to Garrett there and make him equip it, so that way he gets the no synergy. Secret of the Key, or the Secret of Key, shall be revealed to the Disciples of Truth. Well, hey, that's us. Because, well, we obviously just got the Orb of Force. Alright, run on down here. And, well, we're going to leave this place. By the way, just to share a quick story, ow, okay, did not mean to step on that. Back whenever I was a kid and I first played this, it was funny because whenever I used the Dragon Eye, I got confused. I did not know this was an invisible bridge. I thought that you had to actually walk across the dark path, so I kept on, like, walking across the spikes, and I actually never completed this quick little dungeon. And also we have a new enemy, the Mole! So let's go on ahead and try killing that sucker before the end of the video, but I don't think that I will be able to. Well, actually, by the time I kill him, I'm probably going to end up, like, actually having to finish the video. Yeah, but, yeah, whenever I was a kid and I first played this, I never did complete this dungeon in particular, so I never got the Orb of Force. And Garrett is now on level 12, and he learned Heat Wave. Sweet! And Ivan's a level 12 magician, and he learned Sleep. A spell that I will never use throughout this entire game, most likely. No, I just now realized, why didn't I just use the Synergy, retreat instead of running out and, like, wasting time? Oh, well, we're already at the exit anyway, so it's not like it really matters now. But anyways, seeing as how I have already completed the test, I'm going to end this episode right here. So, thank you all for watching Let's Play Golden Sun. I will see you all in the next chapter.